Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the Michigan Wolverines and the LSU Tigers. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
The matchup for the small forward position should be entertaining. Two good young men who often turn some heads at the wing position.
Tonight really should be a good one. We've got two excellent point guards going at it. Number 35 is the kind of leader a coach loves to have out on the floor.
His counterpart tonight is also a guy that likes to lead by example for his team.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Buckle up, folks. Here we go. Michigan takes the tip and starts up the floor. Jackson receives the ball. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Him in the paint, but went elsewhere. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Cross court. He takes the three. Get it to go. On the outside. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
King handles the feed. 10 on the shot clock. Up for two. You can't get away with that. Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
Brad, they like to balance the attack. They don't feel like they can always play up tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think the style works for them.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. He gets it to go.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
They've got him right where they want him. Richard pushes it up. He passes it out of the trap. Jackson receives the pass. Cross court. Turnaround jumper. He takes the rebound. Howard receives the ball. They'll work it around the arc.
The pressure's getting to him, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. He shoots from the top of the key. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Singleton receives the pass. Gave it up. Tries for two. He hacked it. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you what, they can bring a lot of spirit.
To the line for an easy one. Cash it in. Yes. Two at the charity stripe. Looking for a good shot.
some frustration right there.
Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you get the points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well. Great anticipation defensively.
And the jam.
Instead of giving him that, use a foul.
He launches the bomb, drains it. Coach wanting them to set up defensively now. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Jackson handles the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For two, the lane.
Watch your head, young fella.
Looking for a good shot. From the corner. They're getting no good looks at the hoop tonight, Dick.
I don't know what they're doing, but they're squandering away all those easy looks underneath.
The center receives the ball. He tries the three. He doesn't get the hoop. Cross court. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Cross court. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Scorches the net. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass up. Roberts receives the ball.
If substitutions aren't made in the near future, I can guarantee you that there will be some missed shots and silly mistakes.
Riley makes his first appearance.
I tell you, this youngster can provide a spark on either side of the floor, Brad.
Step to the line for the free throw. He got it.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
Down inside.
Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little barista buff in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Start things up again. Inside. There's a bad pass right to the defender. From right of the circle, he hit the deuce and the foul is called.
Nice job of absorbing the foul and keeping his focus.
Chance to get an easy one here. He makes it. Pushes it up. Traps in place, Dick. Passes it out of the trap. Pushes it up. He passes it out of the trap. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He uses the shot fake. Perfectly executed. Weber receives the pass.
Dump it inside.
10 on the shot clock. For the bucket.
For the bump. Says, I like that. Now let's see if he can convert.
Two shots. Gets the first shot. Gets his second. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
As we continue to track the game's tempo.
The tempo is definitely on the slower side. Something that works well for some teams and not so well for others.
Jackson receives the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Seconds showing on the shot clock. Goes up for two. Foul call.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
He misses his second shot. As the crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Singleton goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
And he got a hold. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Jackson receives the ball.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
They're working around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Seconds to put it up. He puts up the three ball. Not this time. Talley receives the ball. Cross court. Riley, subpar performance is just destroying his confidence.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He takes the open jumper. He misses from way outside. Picks off the lazy pass.
The offense is having a hard time finding the open look.
Great defense.
Trying to go inside.
and he'll kick it back outside. They look to get it to the inside with all sorts of time. Number 13 with the three. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin.
Brad and Dick, not too many differences between these two players. Seems as though they're almost canceling each other out on the floor. This now could come down to which team is stronger.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. The power forward gets the ball. He gets the rebound. Singleton handles the feed. Moving it around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound ability.
Both teams looking to get things going here. They work the perimeter.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Singleton receives the pass. Tries for two. In and out. On the outside. For two, perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket, perfectly executed. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Two teams who are picking and choosing where they want to push the ball, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. Arm and foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and all look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. Up and inside.
Will take the shot. Makes it. They work it around the perimeter. A foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Jumped in front to take it away. In the post. Tries for two. Up and in. Weber handles the feed. Momentary look from three-point land. A whistle and a foul. He goes to the line for the first time.
Concentrate. He's got to concentrate on that free-throw line.
Free throw is good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
on the outside. Number 34 fakes the shot. There's a tough shot and one.
He wanted that one, baby. He says you gotta foul me harder than that.
Number 34 steps to the line for the first time.
He sinks it. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Timeout on the floor. They'll talk things over. You've got to be able to execute, and coming out of a timeout, I think it's really important, don't you, Dick?
You know, it's mandatory, Brad. I think it's crucial to have all five players on the same page and ready to execute. Your goal coming out of a timeout should be to get a stop or a score, depending on whether you're on offense or defense.
Sideline. He passes it out of the trap. Fed the low block. Perfectly executed. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
The tempo is definitely on the slower side. Something that works well for some teams and not so well for others.
Cross court. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Perimeter. They get an open look for three. Nope. Rowe handles the feed. Cross court. Takes his jumper. Rowe is really turning some heads right now. He's on fire.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Receives the pass. This defense simply swarms the ball and they cause a 5-second violation. Looking for a good shot.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well.
That bucket counts and he'll go to the line.
Hey, excellent job there. Drawing the foul and finishing the hoop.
Potential for a three-point play. Routine. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Had a little trap really well there, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from the top of the circle. Busts the J.
spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper secures the board.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
The power forward gets the pass. Kicks it out. Turnaround jumper. Rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities. The game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Cross court. That's charging.
What of being selfish with the ball, Brad?
Looking for a good shot. Ball goes out of play. The inbound play will come from the baseline. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He goes up with it. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Cross court. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job by the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
Play on the baseline.
Look at that spacing.
Shot. He hacked him.
Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
This is the second. With a big shot, can't get the long jumper. Would have been good for three. At the half, the Tigers lead by three. Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Well, in one half, in the books, why don't we revisit those points of emphasis, Nick?
Man, Mr. Nessler, I'm looking at this and saying, why aren't there more check marks? This team is not delivering. A poor job of preparing for this game.
All right, then, we'll continue to monitor things as we go into the second half. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Dick, two great players now heading into the second half. We watched them through the first half, and they played it pretty dead even. We'll see what happens here in the second half.
I tell you, there's no doubt they're PT Beers, their primetime performers. They liked the big moment, and they made good plays.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
They get an open three. Goes in. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Tigers did an excellent job of limiting the opposition to just one shot. This was a point of emphasis that Dick brought up earlier, and obviously they were listening. During halftime, the coaching staff commended them on their efforts, but also stressed that it must continue in the second half. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He steps up to the line. It's the first. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Rims out. And they still keep it alive. Another offensive board.
Nobody blocking out. Wide open looks.
He's got an open look for the shot. Whistled for the foul. Steps to the line for the freebie. First shot, no good. Gets the second. Jackson may have escaped one there. Goes up for two. Up and in.
Oh my goodness, that was unbelievable, baby.
King may have escaped one there. Picks off the pass. Jackson's inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
King handles the feed. Tries for two. The lay-in. Dick, look at this highlight. A strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
That's a fantastic play, Brad. That's definitely a candidate for the Pontiac game-changing performance.
Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
They're working around the perimeter. On the shot clock. Gets it off in time. He hits it from way downtown. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Howard receives the ball. Trying to pack it inside.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Boy, assisted turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up with it.
Little bump. Says, I like that. Now let's see if he can convert.
They will line him up. He can't buy one. Nope. He grabs the rebound. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, a two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
Gave it up for two. Got to control yourself. Chance for an easy one. He misses his first shot. A less than stellar performance, I'd say, at the line tonight.
Less than stellar? You too nice a guy, Brad. They're shooting horribly from the line tonight.
Second one, good. Eludes the trap there. He can't get any more open than that. Buries the deuce. Well, whose team tempo will win out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
For the bucket, way off target. Jackson receives the pass. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ten seconds to put up a shot. He went for the steal in the post and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I tell you one thing, what a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their voice is beginning to fade.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout, unorganized, and without a plan.
There might be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Takes away the pass. Williamson may have escaped one there. He puts up the J. The two balls good. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Moving it around the perimeter. Intercepts it. Jackson in the paint. Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Williamson handles the pass. Goes up for two. Can't get it to go. They work the perimeter. Oh,
Pull-up jumper, left side. The Wolverines have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Gaddy's on fire.
On the outside.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
Tries for two. He had baskets good, and he got a little charity for his effort.
Hey, he did a good job of keeping himself under control despite the foul.
Opportunity now for an easy one. It in for two, up and in. Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket, foul charge. Let's check the court side with Aaron Andrews. Aaron.
Brad, in regards to our player matchup, the coaching staff has expected it to be evenly matched up across the board all night long. But you wonder, who's going to be the first one to throw the punch?
That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline.
This is free throws can. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Charging.
Great defense, Brad.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Goes up for two. The lane. Number 34 with the foul. Third team foul. They're set to throw it in from the side. Number 3 takes the pass. Tries for two. Whistle for the foul. How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
Both free throws go. They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad. Hey, dodge one there, Brad.
They've got him trapped.
Great pass out of the trap, Brad.
He pulls up with a jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane. Riley receives the pass.
Coming inside.
He throws it up from downtown. He's money with the shot. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Quick shots, Brad. That's why the tempo gauge is where it's at.
The shooting guard with the ball. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
The center handles the pass. for two.
Tally. The bucket counts and one.
Hey, great composure to take the foul and still get the shot off.
Can he hit the free throw and get the three-point play?
Sinks it.
The shooting guard takes the feed. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Well done. Great trap.
The center with the ball. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket, number 41 is charged with the foul. To the free throw line. First shot is good. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper. They won't let that go. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
And that what makes college so special, the enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Gets the first. Got a move.
Oh, he drained it. That's on the nylon, NBA.
Momentary look from three-point land. Turnaround jumper.
Nice rebound. Then I've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
On the outside. Goes up for two. Up and in. Gave it up. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, a very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball.
They're working around the arc. The ball goes out of bounds. They'll throw this one in from the side. On the dribble, gives it up. Steals a pass. The point guard receives the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Seconds to get a shot off. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Foul charge. Visit the charity strike. Misses the first. Second one, no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Number 41 is called for the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He is going to the line. He can't get one to fall. Number 32 with the ball. Looking for a good shot. For two, number 13 with the defensive foul. 17 foul. Steps to the line for an easy one. First shot, good.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major. Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
Number 13 takes the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
For the bucket, number 34 is whistled for the foul. As we now take a look at our bench score.
Hey, Brad, getting productivity from your bench is always so beneficial. You rarely see good teams win with poor bench production. It means you're a deeper team, it helps your rotation, you can overcome injuries, and you become multidimensional. The list of advantages goes on and on and on.
It's two at the charity stripe. That trap could spell some trouble. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. Kicks it out. Goes up for two. The layup. Dick, this move going to the basket is definitely a candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Wow, Brad, that's a fantastic move. That may be our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Dumps it in. Receives the ball. Tries for two, and he can't hit the shot. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
Number three handles the feed.
Dump it inside.
For two, number 32 picks up the defensive foul. First personal foul.
Shooting. No,
the free throw line. Opportunity. It's good. Second shot is no good. We've got a timeout here. Nick, what'd you try to focus on during your timeouts?
You know, Brad, I think it's very important. It's essential that you know the time, the score, and the situation, and make sure that every player knows what our options are, both offensively and defensively.
Let's get back to the action.
Look at that spacing.
Start the bus moment, courtesy of our good friends at State Farm. The small forward with the ball. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
10 on the shot clock. We have a backcourt violation.
Mistakes like that can add up in games like this.
The offense sets up from the sideline. Gave it up. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
He's out of control, baby, out of control. I'd say he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Definitely a foul. Well, Dick, there's a look at the foul situation.
Well, you know, Brad, a lot of times the first team to the bonus will get the advantage. That means they're playing aggressive basketball. It means they get to the charity stripe quicker and have an opportunity to rack up some easy points. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Dribble, gives it up. Eludes the trap there. Gave it up. Oh, that's charging.
Great defense, Brad.
Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble, that stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line, out of bonus situation.
perimeter with a bucket.
Little bump. Says, I like that. Now let's see if he can convert.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. Escape the trap.
O'Neal receives the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock. O'Neal receives the pass. You can't get away with that. O'Neal. Step to the line for the free throw. Takes the shot. Trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two and off the mark. Number 13 gets the ball. Cross court. Tries for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. For two. The layup is good. Pushes it up. Picked out of the air. Shot clock is dead. The dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper. Nope. He grabs the board. Kicks it out. Dick, what are your final thoughts, man? How these teams play?
Brad, it's all about solid game plan. Teams who come prepared and know what the important points are will be successful more times than not. Having skilled players on your roster helps, but by no means is it mandatory.
Playing within yourself and your abilities is what it's all about. We say it time and time again. LSU comes away with a huge win tonight in this blowout.
After a game like that, it's hard to believe that these two teams were close in the standings.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.
Hello, hello. Why did that change? Sorry about that, guys. My mic changed to a different setting, apparently. I don't know what the hell that was. Anyway, yeah, I thought LSU could win that game, but I didn't think it would be a blowout like that. So let's get this over here. Get this plugged in. So, first game ended up being a 9-point game, but it was much more entertaining. So back and forth for quite a while, until the end that the other team could pull away. That game, not so much. It was pretty close first half, and then Couldn't seem to make any shots. So let's go over here. All right, so there's what the scores for game 16 for everybody look like. We'll put it up on the schedule uniform so you can see it a little better if you prefer that version. It'll be up on YouTube later, so you can pause it over there if you want to take a deeper dive into it. I do have a couple that are too long to show the records at the end, like the Running Rebels here. I haven't really bothered to fix it, but I think it would just be scaling those down. But these are in frames, so I'd have to go through each one and scale them down for the belt and the same. So there's no fit to a box that I have found for the frame stuff. There's only one or two that have that issue. They're on here somewhere. So that's what the finals look like for this week. Close that out and we'll look at game 17. I didn't want to call these weeks because in basketball, you guys you might have a team play more for them, so it's not really a good schedule for basketball. And then if you prefer this version, we'll look at that. Here's the matchups, game 17 for everybody. I tell you what, if LSU plays like that in the Classic Madness, they could actually give 89 Syracuse or 91 out of UNLV run for their money, both of which are still. The Rebels playing number 18 UMass. I don't think that'll be too tough for them. It's other ranked teams, so we'll see. It didn't seem to change the standings, rankings too much with any of the results. They were 5-9 going in. They're 5-9 now. So, and then the first two, I don't think changed either based on their result, which is kind of odd because I thought one of them would drop out. They lost, but they did not. So, which we're gonna go look at right now. Again, if you guys want to check these out in further detail, you can. Catch them out on YouTube. Pause it to take a closer look. Interesting. Very strange. So I'll have to keep an eye on that to make sure something's not broken. And then we'll pull that up in this fashion for that week. And again, you can pause it over on the side background. Instead of white. All right, so there's that one if you want to check it out that way on the YouTube channel. And then we'll take a look at the matchup for Classic Madness. If it started now, it doesn't look like anything changed there. Matchup wise. And there's that for that. Also, again, these will not matter where they are in the bracket. It will match up the highest and lowest in the next round. So where they are on this bracket does not make any difference. It only matters who they play that round. So keep that in mind going forward. And I do believe the college football is that way as well. And then the pros tomorrow, they're not that way. They go by the, which is basically the way NFL does it. And that's how they're set up. It's the way NFL has it. So we will be back in a little bit once we get everything set up.